Okay, that kind of sucked. I even had the bar up there to watch my time, and I wasn't even paying attention to it. I'm just not used to it being there. I can't even drag it. That's just lame. All right. So anyway, what was I saying? Okay, you put your points into here, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and 30. And you got your different abilities, so that's what I was saying. You got your abilities, like for a thief, you have one ability where when you dodge, you lay down these like tacks on the ground, and when they walk across them, it causes a bleed effect on the enemy, and it cripples them. They'll actually start hobbling towards you. They can't. It actually cripples them, and they start walking really slowly, like an undead creature, for a certain amount of time. So there's some pretty neat skills traits for that. These are your skill points right here, and then these are your trait points. You have your story here. If you want to figure out what your quest, what quest you're on, and where you need to go, you can also look up here as well. You have your crafting. For crafting, it's kind of annoying having to do this again, but breathe and let's get on with it. Okay. For crafting, it really sucks when you have to say something more than once. Okay, so you got your crafting here. You got armor smithing. You have your weapon smithing, which is right here. Artificing, which is jewelry. And where is it? There it is. Leather working station. And then you have your huntsman station, which is like bows and staffs. And your cooking station, which is kind of neat. There's some actually pretty neat things you can cook up that give you buffs and stuff like that. Then you have your armor smith. There it is. And then tailoring. There's a lot of crafting options. One neat thing is that you can learn them all. But you can only have two crafting abilities at a time. Now, if you want, you can give one up and learn a different one. You won't learn, and you will not lose what you've learned. You'll still have what you've learned, but you're not able to access it because you traded it for one of the other ones. Now, you can always go back later and then build something, and then, you know, you can swap them back and forth, but you can only have two at a time. And it will cost you coin to swap these. To learn these, just go up to the stations. There should be somebody standing next to them that will teach you these abilities and allow you to change them out back and forth. You can get your crafting recipes from these karma merchants, which you can get from world versus world or PvP. But I'm going to go ahead and teach you crafting, and then I'll teach you about how to get these karma merchant points. So, we're going to lower that. Actually, we're going to raise that. I need a port near here. And we're going to port there. Okay. Now I turned some of the sound options down or off pretty much, just so that y'all didn't get distracted and so I didn't get distracted mainly. Okay, and when you hear a ding like that, that means somebody whispered you or a friend came on. Which is annoying. There's no way for me to turn that off. So, anyway. Let's go to one that I have. And this will be a good example, and then you can just kind of get an idea what you need to do from there. Now, what you'll do is, as you're crafting around, you'll have to get some tools, and you can just go to a regular merchant and that sells general goods and stuff like that, and just purchase gathering tool for gathering herbals and for mining and for wood cutting. That's all you need. And then, as you gather these materials, you're going to see them pop up in here. And it's going to start to fill your bag. And once your bag's full, you're like, well, crap, I can't get anything else. My bag's full. Well, here's what you can do that's neat in this game is that you click this little icon right here. And you're going to say, deposit all collectibles. You saw my little mini pet. He disappeared. And then what's going to happen is you're like, well, where the hell did they go? Well, what you do is you go to your bank. Or in this case, I'm at my armor smithing station. And I can access my bank here. And then what you'll do is you'll go to collections. And here they are. It will automatically sort them into categories for cooking, Common crafting materials. Fine crafting materials. Gemstones and jewels. And then your mini pets, which is, there he is. And you can also click these if you want to minimize them. I'll go ahead and tell you what these are. This is cooking. That's a doughy. You got your common crafting materials, which is armor crafting. And then fine crafting materials, which is weapon smithing. And these gemstones are stat stones that you can put on your gear. Which is... wrong button. Well, you see how it says garnet pebble 3 power? Basically all you do is you double click the stone and then click which gear you want it on. And what you're going to see is see how it says unused upgrade slot? All you do is you just look for one of those and you'll put it into that. You can replace them, but you'll lose the one you replace. Okay, let's go ahead back into here. Now what you'll do is you go into your collections, gather your materials for the station that you're at. Then you're going to go to production. Now what you'll notice is that when you've learned a profession and crafting, in this case armor smithing, you're going to have all these recipes. The word slipped my mind. You'll have all these recipes that you already have. As you advance in leveling up, you'll gain new recipes, but that's not to say that you can't find other recipes, which you can get with karma points or finding the auction house. So, anyway, you'll have your collected items that you've gathered, and it will list a number if you're able to craft that item if you have the materials for it. If you don't, you can just simply click here and it'll say, I need one bronze ingot. Okay, I'll go to the auction house or I'll go ahead and make one. Simple enough. Once you've done that, you're going to find that you need a casting helmet and then a lining helmet. In order to make the helmet, you need both items made. And then you will go into discovery, put it into here and here. And then what you can do is you will also find out that you can make insignias. Insignias are, for this one, it puts a healing ability on the gear, or it can put precision or toughness. These are stats that you can put onto your armor by building these insignias, and then you combine them with the armor that you want to make. In this case, it would be a helmet. So I put the two pieces of the helmet that make the one whole helmet. Then I'll put insignias in here, and that'll combine all together, and it'll craft that. And what's really neat is you can take those materials that you already have, the like minerals and that you've gathered in the wood, and not do anything with them. And you can combine them in here, and it will tell you, hey, if you combined that with that, we know, it'll say down here, it'll say you can craft two items, but we don't know what those two items are. And you'll say, okay, so you click craft, and it's going to craft something, and it'll go, hey, this is what it makes. You now have a new recipe that you've learned, and you know that by putting this and this together, it makes this. And then what's going to happen is that you're going to go to production, and you're going to see that new recipe that you learned in there. So that's pretty neat. Also, the fastest way to level is by crafting. But you didn't hear that from me. I talked to one guy who's a level 66. He leveled, he said, mainly by crafting. I know, right? And he did it in 27 hours. I'm sure somebody's beat that record, though. Somebody who doesn't have a life. let's open this up. You'll notice over here that you have... I've noticed one thing that is kind of funny is that they have these bat capes. But you'll notice that my character doesn't have one, and I have yet to actually see this item listed in the game. So I'm kind of wondering if this item even exists yet. I haven't seen anybody wear any either, so I think that's kind of funny. But anyway, you'll have your accessories. You'll have two. And you'll have your two rings, and you'll have your amulet. You can find these in an auction house, or you can make them yourselves if you have the crafting ability, which would be called artificing. Let's see, what else can I teach you? What else? Let's close that.